Ananda, also known as Veda Babaji, the great Himalayan yogi from Dwarahat. He is going to enlighten us on the Himalayas. Please welcome him. Thank you,
sir. Good morning. Just try to follow me and say three words. I want to say, you repeat it. I love you. Please say. I love you. I love you. I love you. Yes, yes. We born for loving. We have to love. We have to live for love. If you want to live, you must love. No other way. But we are searching many, many, many ways for living. Here, small problem. Himalayan masters means they are sometimes beyond body, very less times within body and with body. That is the problem. Many times they are away beyond words. Many times beyond words, beyond expression, physically, that is the problem. So if we want to capture the wisdom of their mission or their existence, means very, very, very difficult. What I experienced, whatever I am saying, this is my experience, may be liked by people or I don't know, what I got from Himalayas. Since 25 years I am roaming and I am staying in Himalayas. Masters pulled me, made me to go there and roam there. Master, master, master. Without master nothing can be achieved. That too, grand master is required. Masters will be many, grand master will be only one. Mastership starts, in my view, whatever the wisdom I got from my master, Himalayan master, Sri Mahavatar Babaji, and his energy came to the world Karma Bhumi in the name of Shirdi Sai Baba. These two names and energies made me to talk. I am sharing with you. That's all. Both are beyond bodies. Just Shirdi Sai Baba came to world and stayed in Shirdi, smallest village. More than 60 years or something, but he is very silent, less words, no writings. So if we want to put their wisdom into words or books means it is very, 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 very difficult. They are asking to experience. Sister, now she did greatest thing. She made us to expand ourselves. Yes. It is inner matter, not outer matter. That is what Himalayan masters are telling. Himalaya mountains are outwardly, they are something, parvat, mountain. But if you see outside, dust, rocks, or something, snow, coolest, cool, something. But if you go with concentration, consciousness, approach with beyondness, they are not mountains. They are sages, saints, mauna sadhus, silent sages experience it. Without master, we cannot reach. My masters, I told, in two names, one master. If you start understanding, only one master in universe. One earth, one truth. We are one. Their slogan, great of them. Let us clap to them. Yes. Only one is there. Here also, no many. Only one is sitting and one is hearing, one is talking, one is digesting. One will go out and do the things in oneness. That is the expectation of this parliament. One must go out, not many. But while coming, we may be many. After going, we must be one. With oneness, we will go out. We have to go out like that. So, like that, mastership. Individual becomes master means individuality may be having name form, but mastership is beyond name form. That's why an individual ordinary person, by approaching a Sadguru or great master, grand master, he becomes master. Before that, he is like a ordinary person, a student. From LKG onwards, studentship starts. One day we will reach to PhD. We will do PhD, professionalism, professor. Then his role will be different, energy will be different, his words will be different. Before that, if we go to back, when at the age of 5 years something, he is little child. How he became professor and professional means with the help of gurus and masters, sadgurus. That's what I learned. So everybody needs master. Without master, we cannot do anything. For a small technique, if you want to know cycle repairing, there must be somebody to teach you cycle repairing. Then only you can become mechanic. Cycle mechanic. Otherwise, you cannot. Same way, for everything, there must be a good master for us. People are asking many places, wherever I go, they will ask, how to recognize master? There are many, many thousands, millions of masters. We are reading, we are observing in channels, Asta channel, like that, many channels, we are seeing many, many masters. How to recognize my master? Who is suitable to me? Whom I can approach completely, dedicatedly, totally? Yes, that is problem nowadays. Because here something is happening. Our indriyas are misleading sometimes. Mind is coming and calculations it is developing. So our calculations to the person in front of us in the name of Sadguru or Master, Grand Master. Mind creates something, brings something. But here truth is something. So mind level truth, body level truth, and worldly truth, and heart level truth, and divine truth. Many truths are there. That's why these people told only one truth. Let us realize by coming here and by spending 5 days here. Really, nearly, only one truth is there. But we are living in many truths. That's why morning one way, afternoon one way, night one way we are living. Because we are away from the real truth. That's what Himalayan masters are telling to me, told me. Kriya Yoga. Kriya Yoga is the, from that path, that instrument, greatest instrument for a ordinary person to anybody, everybody, that is the greatest instrument. If we can recognize and capture and collect and utilize it properly, greatest path, Kriya Yoga. There also I asked Mahavatar, yes, Kriya Yoga is greatest path. Okay, as you gave to Lahiriji, Grand Master of this age. So how to proceed an ordinary person? Nowadays, confusion. On that name also, many, many going for initiations, dropping themselves. I'm finding 70% droppings. I'm surprising. When going very much curious and emotional, taking that, I cannot do 2 hours, 2.5 hours. I cannot do that inner, that whatever the technique they told. They're telling feedback I got. That's why I asked, how to? You tell me something, simplest way to do Kriya Yoga. Is there anything, internal facility, internal easiness? People are dropping. He answered me very affectionately. He told me, this is my experience I'm telling. Kriya Yoga means doing all Kriyas with the flavor of yoga, yogic. Not doing yogic Kriyas. Yogic Kriyas status is afterwards. First you do whatever you do, make it yoga. Nearing to divinity, nearing to God. Godliness. If you feel godliness in your actions, that becomes Kriya Yoga. That's what he told. Because we cannot live without doing any actions, karma. Without karma, we cannot live. You make every karma divine, godly, spiritually, heartfully. That is Kriya Yoga, what he told, greatest. Yes. We need not go and get the biggest technique, something new technique, that technique, this technique. We know how to excel. We know how to inhale. We know how to eat. We know how to drink. We know how to give. We know how to receive. when to receive, what to receive. We are doing many, many kriyas, many things. You approach divinely. You approach with the simplicity. You approach with the support of God. How to reach God, that is different. But what he told. So you cannot stop doing the kriyas. So make it. When you asking, simply, pardon me. If you start like this, other person certainly reacts to you. He will give you, certainly will give you positive. If you say, hey, can you give? If you ask like that, simply, ja, go away. He will say, recklessly will answer you. So, when you want something, you approach politely. That is, asking kriya must be divine. Kriya must be divine. Wisdom, master's wisdom, Himalayan master's wisdom is simplest, saral sahaja. Yes, very simple. Simple, no difficult. If you cross your house, your boundaries, bodily and mentally and karma, if you cross, if you reach to Devabhumi, Yogabhumi, that land of yogis and gods, Himalayas, very easy living, no complication, no big karma kandas, nothing. Just simply, you take small cup of gel and one tulsi or one leaf, any leaf with Shraddha, you keep on Sivalinga, Shiva will come down. If you do with Shraddha, that's what Himalayan masters told me. That's why north and from Haridwar onwards, Haridwar, gateway to Hari, Haridwar starts. From there, if you do karmas and kriyas, actions, thinking, thought level, everything do with Shraddha, faith, naturally manifestation starts from there. Karma Bhumi, here, land of karmas, very difficult because we linked with many karmas, others, this, that, this, relationships, expectations, desires. Suffering comes from desires, attachment, expectations, I feel. Suffering, we are inviting suffering through these things, through three. We cannot live without three. Because in Karma Bhumi, we need three. We have to follow three. That's why suffering also following with us. I feel I got understanding from masters. Mother is the first guru for everybody. If you really devote mother, if you touch her feet every day, you need not go to any temple. I got that message. You need not go to any temple. Mother is the first guru. You got guru in your own house. You born with the help of mother. Guru, Sadguru, in the form of mother. That Sadguru gave you blood, gave you everything. Made you taught you to wear the clothes, taught you to eat the food, everything. You learned from that Sadguru in the form of mother. But we are missing, we are searching world, we are roaming like anything for Sadguru. Mother. If you realize mother, there from starts your Guru Krupa, Guru Shakti, Guru Blessing. So already you got Guru. So if she teaches a lot and she makes you to live to some extent and sends you to go out and learn something by going to schools and colleges. So there starts another form of gurus. With particular subject, science guru, maths guru. We call them teachers, gurus. So gurus will be many in every class. They will teach us and cross us that class and go to next class to where you go till you get Sadguru and Inner Guru and Atma Guru. To that extent, you must go on crossing the classes. Don't stop anywhere. Gurus came to teach you some limited concept with unlimitedness. Limited concept, puja, Mantra Guru will teach you mantras with depth and everything detailed and teaches you. You go now. Do sadhana with mantras and achieve something, knowledge or something, next step you go. Real gurus won't stop you, they will make you to go out. That is what I learned from Himalayas. Freedom is our destiny. Freedom. If you క్లోజ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ యూ కెనాట్ గెట్ ఎనీథింగ్. ఓపెన్ ఓపెన్ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు దిస్ డే, బట్ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు అవర్ లైఫ్. నౌ వీ సాట్, వీ ఓపెన్డ్ అవర్ ఐస్. వెన్ ఎవర్ యూ ఓపెన్ యువర్ ఐస్, దట్ ఈస్ మార్నింగ్ ఫర్ అస్. ఎవ్రీ డే మార్నింగ్ వీఆర్ ఫీలింగ్. సో వెన్ యూ డూ మెడిటేషన్ అండ్ ఓపెన్ యువర్ ఐస్ మీన్స్ యువర్ రియల్ మార్నింగ్ స్టార్టెడ్ ఇన్ యువర్ లైఫ్, నాట్ డే. So try to open your eyes and keep it all the day. Morning can be, all the life morning can be. Rising sun you can see, rises of sun you can see, every minute, every minute. That master says meditation is not half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours and evening, morning matter, not at all. It's not the matter of time, it is matter of 24 hours meditation. That means you live in meditation, means you do everything in meditation. That is what Kriya Yoga. You do everything with yogic yoga, yog, nearing to God, feel nearness with God and do the karmas. That is what Kriya Yoga. Birth a great kriya. Death is a greatest kriya. It will come and capture you. Greatest kriya is already destined. That must be followed. You cannot escape from that kriya. In between, mahakriya is life. Mahakriya this is. We are doing, what we are facing, what we are giving, taking, crying and smiling. All kriyas through body with the help of indriyas. If you do kriyas with the help of indriyas and mind, their flavor will be something else. If you do the same kriyas with the help of heart, their flavor will be something else. That is what masters are telling. Try to act with heart. Try to know your anahata. Try to live maximum in anahata. When you put namaskar in the front of anahata, naturally energy comes. If you say something, you cannot get. Anahata is powerful center for everybody. That's why mother, whenever child cries, na mother takes to anahata and keeps here and hugs that child. Don't worry, she will pad and keeps here. She teaches like that. Through that kriya, she teaches you love, unconditional love. That is another word of Himalayan masters, unconditional love. So a lot of things simply within 15 minutes or something, because I experience, na experience has got no limit. More thirst, more curiosity about experiences. One experience get more. That way I am getting many things from Himalayan masters. With their direction, with their word, I went to Dwarahat, where Lahiri Mahase gave diksha to Mahavatar gave diksha to Lahiri Mahase in Kakuchina village on Dronagiri Parvat. There Mahavatar asked me to construct small ashram like for sadhakas. He asked me, land is ready, you go. He told me in Rishikesh. I went blindly. I got land. I would construct one ashram there, Tapovan ashram. So like that they are directing me to do Loka Kalyana, living for others. So that way we are roaming. Very fortunate, delighted, very much happy to see you all. So where God means like this. God is there here itself. If we can understand, see the faces, see the energy and tune with these souls. So my dear soulmates, my dear divine lovers, please let us develop love. Love is the only source in this life. Nothing else. For love we need many techniques maybe, but our destiny must be love. That's all. Not money, not fame, not something. Please, thanks to all of you. Time is over. But I expressed my immaturity or matured words, whatever it may be, maturity or immaturity. This is what I expressed. Thanks a lot for hearing me. Jai Sadguru, all the best to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.